professor discovered the best way to write my statement of the problem in my research papers. No editor has ever complained or corrected my problem statement. Really, I wish I knew this when I was Hello, intellect. This is Insights for You today. If you're new to this channel, please subscribe so that we can help you achieve your academic goals using modern technologies. Just hit the subscribe button down below. A statement problem is actually just one sentence, but is preceded by one or few paragraphs, which may make your statement of problem very interesting. I knew that writing my statement of problem is the most important part of my research if I really wanted to justify my research purpose. So I paid critical attention to it. Don't get me wrong, writing a statement of problem before now was really a nightmare for me. When I was a student, I had some terrible statements of problem. There was barely a time I wrote a statement of problem that it wasn't turned down. It was hashtag problem not well stated. That was the usual thing I always got in all my statement of problem. But today, my statement of problem is always on point. I have always helped many students and academics write their statement of problem without corrections, except for a few typographical errors. How did I achieve this? I did a little research on how to write a statement of problem, and I got the deal. Now, I write my statement of problem in less than 5 minutes. I'll show you how I did this. For this tutorial, let's use the research I carried out on plagiarism among academics in universities in Nigeria. As I wrote my background to the study, you know what I mean by background to the study? That beginning part of your research where you get to review existing literature on the area of your research interest. So what I did was that I tried to notice the gaps in all the studies I reviewed. I noticed that almost all studies I found on Google Scholar, Science Direct, PubMed, and other scholarly databases on my subject of interest were plagiarism among students, not academics. So I wrote it down on a note I considered my draft. I also noticed a few studies on plagiarism among academics, but they were carried out in developed nations. None was done in a country like Nigeria. Yeah. More gaps were really identified. There was obviously a paucity of literature examining plagiarism among academics, despite its prevalence among lecturers. There were several studies on plagiarism, but the focus was on students. I also noticed that most studies focused on the extent to which people plagiarize, but my objective was to find out predictors of plagiarism among academics, which was grossly lacking. No matter your research interest, there is always a gap. If there is no gap, it means your study is not significant. You may need to change it or make some adjustments. So I outlined the gaps I found and made them as clear as possible. That is exactly what I expect you to do right after this video. Then I try to find out what is the ideal situation. Using my current research on plagiarism among academics, I wrote the problem or the gap I identified clearly by first setting what is the ideal situation and what it should be like. Then I try to find out what the real situation was. This is what I had to write. Then I wrote my study purpose, statement of the objective, and scope of the project being proposed in a final statement. Just look at your screen. Put them all together and your statement of the problem is ready. To intellect, that is it. Very simple, right? If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, please do so now. And don't forget to hit the notification bell, as next week I'm going to show you how to write a literature review in less than 30 minutes. So thanks a lot for watching. See you in my next video. Be safe. Bye.